Men in Black.
Check, check. Slap.
Slap one.
Slap one. We got to put it right here so I can see it.
We Eating presents the Free 99 Podcast. Follow us on SoundCloud, iTunes, YouTube, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and Instagram. Search FREE99 Podcast. Be sure to listen, like, comment, subscribe. Sometimes I put the at. So if, like, on SoundCloud, it says at Free99 Podcast because that's going to be a wave. And we can be one of the first fuckers on that shit to put at as already part of the part of your name. Like, what, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like .com, like sticker app.
You know what I mean? At
that. Yeah. All right, whatever. Oh, yeah, yeah, we still doing it. Shout out to the sponsors, We Eating, the F-Word Clothing Company, F-WordClothingCo.com, and the Video Productions. Possibly you. Email us, askfree99@gmail.com. Mono in the building. Philly Phil in the building.
What up?
And this is episode 50 to my brothers. Can I get a toast? Episode 50.
50. Oh,
love, love, love. Woo. 50. Congratulations, gentlemen.
We survived.
Yeah, that was my goal for this annual year was to hit 50. And I want to give a special shout out. If you search them on, let's say, on Yelp or anything else, it's going to be called Braised Bread. Braised Bread. But if you search for them on, they're rebranding themselves to Slap Moan. Oh, I hope I said that right.
Slap Moan.
Shout out to the lovely couple over there, Slap Moan. That's a real family business out here in the city of San Francisco. It's Cambodian food, but they got this thing called a Filipino friend. Their chicken's on point. Yeah, it's back there. They gave us hella food. They gave us hella food. You gonna grab that real quick? Yeah, they gave us hella food. So shout out to Slap Moan. Let me get that address for y'all. So you know what it is. Address is, it's in the Crocker Galleria.
Just do it right now. Go.
Crocker Galleria. Where's his address at? Sorry, y'all. What happened? Slap
One.
50 Post Street, Suite 65. So if you go up in there, you have to go all the way up and you're gonna go to the left. So Braised Bread. What'd you do? What happened?
I'm trying to show the...
Oh, yeah. That was chicken right there.
What's it called?
That one is the... I took a picture of the menu because I knew you were going to ask me this.
Filipino friend.
Yeah. Is it?
Mm-hmm. Filipino friend.
With orange... Yeah, this is the orange habanero sauce.
With an egg.
The egg. Rice. And that... what does the Filipino friend have? Let me just get here. Sorry. Y'all can't be doing this to me.
Hey, don't worry. I did it to myself.
Yeah. Is that right?
Yeah.
You spill?
No.
Okay.
We good. We good.
All right.
Just like nothing happened.
I guess I'll catch that one. Oh, Filipino friend.
Damn,
that's good. Four wings, rice, egg, master sauce, and fried garlic. Let me see here. There is Reggie, which is 8 wings, rice, and a salad. Reggie on a diet is... No. Reggie is 8 wings, rice, and a salad. Reggie on a diet is 4 wings, rice, and a salad. Dirty meal, 4 wings, fries, and Cambodian dirt. And this is their Cambodian dirt. They sell that at the store.
It's like a rep?
It's like that last ha. Right when it comes out the fryer, like he let me go back in the kitchen. He fried it, and then he slapped that on right there. So, yeah, that's that dirty sauce right there.
Ooh.
If they don't know, I'm looking at it on Yelp. It's Braised plus sign Bray.
Yeah, Braised plus sign Bray. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah,
Shout out, Mono. Thank you.
Braised plus bread.
There's Nudie and Wings, 4 wings. Slap Moan garlic noodles. That's this one right here. And there's a Shit I'm Hungry. Shit you not. That's the name of the mint. That's the name of the food. Shit I'm Hungry. 12 wings, rice, egg, salad, and broth.
I think I could do that.
I get it. I get it.
The broth should come with everything.
That's true. But then the way they move in units downtown, I ain't trying to give everyone that extra container.
Yeah, that's
an extra 50 cents. Like, that's container soup. You know what I mean?
I feel like only the real ones, like, get the sabao with their food. Like, like a potet don't get broth with their...
No, but that's why that Rooster Rice spot is so popping, because it comes with the sabao. You know what I mean? It come with that chicken broth.
Sauce. Mm-hmm. Sauce.
Yeah. But Slap Moan, great couple from SoCal. They doing it. Their lease is actually going to be up at the end of March of 2020. So they're looking to relocate. So if you know anyone that's looking to rent out a spot to Solid People, that's a family business. I rock with that. Solid People, family business. Schlappmann, braised plus sign bread, braised bread, solid food.
Do they have a food truck?
They do not. They run out of a kitchen in the Galleria.
They need a food truck.
That would probably be the next told move. Them that, and yeah. They said there's a lot of hoops to jump through, and I think they already spend their money on the equipment. Well, I don't know. I don't know your business, but if they're looking for a spot, you know anyone that got a place with a hood because they frying chicken. Your chicken's good.
I got my kitchen.
You got your kitchen
fried up all day.
You want to try these right now?
Yeah.
Okay, let's crack. Hey, I got chopsticks.
What are we trying first?
I'm just grabbing a wing. Well, these I ain't had any noodles yet though, so.
The one and only noodles they gave us is on display for the camera. We got to leave it there for them to
check
to
this look out. At. I got chopsticks, man. I came out here prepared for this.
Right. I'm gonna try this one right here.
Do you?
Hey Gus, you used to manage a food truck. Is the paperwork for a restaurant and a food truck the same?
I was very fortunate to where someone else handled the paperwork, and I just handled the function of the truck.
Oh, okay.
That's real.
Yeah.
And then I don't know if she listens, but shout out to Lanisa because she helped me out. She held me down for that food truck and everyone that was part of the truck. Justin, Kinder, the whole family. That shit was a beast to manage because you can't control flow of. Work, you know what I mean? It's unpredictable.
Yeah.
How's that feel?
It is. Put that sauce.
So what sauce is that? That sauce is.
I think it's like a mango habanero.
No, it says it on the box.
Oh.
Mandarin.
Orange habanero.
Orange habanero.
Yeah. You sure don't want the orange? I mean, mango, whatever.
I'm just purist with the straight wing. Hey, it's still crispy.
Yeah.
And this is like two. Okay, hold on. What time is it right now? This is almost 2.5 hours after I picked it up. I felt like home when I was there. Okay. No lie. That's a real, like, go support small business. Hey.
I'll take this over Bonchon any day.
Yeah.
That's a good wing.
Huh?
It's a good wing.
For 2 hours ago, though.
You gotta judge a wing with no sauce, right?
Exactly. Okay. Hold on.
Wing's good, no sauce.
Let me do that crunch, though.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I like it. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
I would go here. I would definitely go here.
I would go search them out.
Yeah.
To go eat.
Hey, and they're only open right now, Monday to Friday. They don't open on the weekends, I think.
What time they close?
About
to be in the city tomorrow.
3 o'clock?
Really?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's early. I was going to get to lunchtime, too.
Yeah. And the drumsticks is on some secret menu shit. Shout out to the fam. They hooked up with drumsticks, so I want to make sure y'all seen that, but that's some secret menu shit, boy. I don't got to do the sauce. Go ahead, try some noodles.
I just want to try their egg over here.
Their rice, that Filipino friend they got there that Phil's working on, that rice is the one. You know how rice you got to, like, hey, this is cold, too. I'm just saying, it's cold. Like, it was sitting next to me at work and then in transit.
Try it.
Uh-huh. Hey, real talk to Mono, right?
Yeah.
No, real, that's good. Imagine you got this fresh out.
We're not getting paid to say what we're saying right really now.
This is actually good food.
But if you want to pay us, I am so down.
I'm with it.
Yeah.
Try this.
This is like ramen garlic noodles.
Ramen garlic noodles right one? There.
Nice. Hot sauce?
I don't know what. See, it's on the side of the box.
Reggie on a diet.
What's the sauce, though? Get like me.
It's spicy peanut.
Spicy peanut sauce. Ooh, spicy peanut sauce.
Easy.
Mono.
Yo, that's the ramen noodle without the soup, and it straight up just tastes like a garlic noodle.
Mm-hmm.
That's exactly what I was looking for.
Really, though?
When I looked at it, that's exactly what I wanted to... pause. That's exactly what I wanted to taste.
Man, I'm saying. So, this is the spicy peanut... This is spicy. Go, Mono. Crack that spicy peanut. We working right now. I don't want to eat this anymore because all the skin's gone.
Look at that.
I'm just saying, though. Slap one. Hey, right? First time I ate there, I paid.
Good. Yeah, it's good.
Yeah, first time I ate there, I paid, and I hit up dude on IG. I go, hey, y'all fry some fucking chicken. I was like, hey, y'all fry some chicken. But shout out to my boy Christian SFC. We hitting you up too. But I'm just letting everyone know, like, this, this man.
About to hear a whole hour of eating.
What's the IG?
IG is S H L A P. MUAN. That's the main account. They have a braised bread as well. But Schlamp Wine is where we want to push everyone towards. Hey, that's a good piece of chicken. Let me put my.
If you're yelping it, it's braised plus sign.
Braised plus sign bread. Crocker Galleria. It's one of those spots that's only open during the weekday. So when you downtown,
what you got one napkin to wear?
Oh, sorry. Here we go. Dad move, mono pulled a dad move, mono pulled a dad move. Right. Oh, let me get that. All right, well, I'm gonna take a little swiggy swig, a little swiggy.
Yeah, that's good.
Episode 50.
I like this orange habanero.
He makes all his own sauces. That dude Hawk is a beast. He makes all his own sauces. This is his, like, I watched him bag this. Like, you know how, like, you go in the kitchen and they have a big Tupperware and that's, like, their secret sauce? Mm-hmm. He had that shit already in a box, like, secret sauce. Then he pulled out one of these baggies like he's doing the thing and he popped it open.
They put that on this after?
Yes. Cambodian dirt. Mm. Cambodian dirt. Mm. He has it over at, what's that place? He sells it off of Mission Street. There's a spot there. You told me about it. Let me just check it real quick. One time. I'm sorry.
Hold on. I'm just double dipping in this.
Yeah. That's yours now. Those are yours. Those belong to him now.
There's another one in here. You try that egg?
Yeah.
There's another one in the back with sweet spicy garlic. Mm. You want to crack that one out so you can flavor it up? They're selling it over at the shop, Dolores Outpost in the Mission. They're solid spot. March 31st is the end of the lease. So they are a small business and they do a good job. If you could go support them, maybe by this extra push, you know, they'll find another spot. You know, we want to support small business because that's what it is. And that's what we are.
I support him.
Small business, big dreams. Was that the S? And the SD card is full. So, yeah. So it's all good. You gonna swap that on out?
I will.
All right. Yeah. Let's get that pop.
Should we just pause it?
Yeah. Pause it, Mono.
Oh. I'll probably eat some more.
Is it on?
All right.
Sorry for that, technical difficulties. That break was brought to you by Schlapman. Dirty Cambodian seasoning. Solid. What sauce was that, Mono, that you just had?
It was the orange one.
The orange one is orange habanero. There is sweet, spicy garlic.
Spicy garlic.
And then that was spicy peanut. Hey, Schlapman. You know it's a good spot when they're only open, like, on weekdays. Those are the ones you
hate. And only lunchtime.
Yeah, it's like, fuck. Because, they're at a place to where they make all their money during that time. Why be open and waste money? So, hey, they on their hustle, man.
That shit was
good. Yeah. Yeah, no, I'm saying.
I can't wait for this episode to end so I can eat some more.
They sell it. And Mono, what'd you say? You said flats or drumsticks?
Flats or drums. Where are you guys?
I'm all about the flats, dude.
Yeah, I'm all about drums.
Really?
Yeah.
Drumsticks?
Wow. Yeah.
Okay.
But really? But I perfected the way to eat a flat.
Okay.
I perfected the way. So
let's see you demonstrate this thing right here.
What's this motherfucker at? You don't want to see. All right, fine. For the culture.
Let's see how you perfect this thing. All
right, so.
Perfect this thing.
All right.
You just... All in one shot.
You know, like a fishbone in cartoons. They put a whole fish in their mouth. All right. So when you look at a wing, right, it has has sections where the joints meet. So you just got to crack it at one of those sections. Bam.
Uh-huh.
That's it. And then you got two drums. You have two.
Oh, man, I thought you were going to do that. Yeah, come on.
You ain't showed us nothing new. God,
yeah. People say the twist method. You hold the joints and you twist and it comes apart just that same way.
I want to perfect how to make lollipop chicken.
The fuck is lollipop chicken?
You never had lollipop chicken?
Like Hunan? Yeah, Hunan? Like,
Sky Dragon?
Yeah, Sky Dragon.
South City?
It's like deep fried chicken wings that they cut. It's pretty much a flat that they make into a drum.
Yeah.
Right?
I don't know how they do it. You know how they do it?
I Googled it. I probably YouTubed it. I YouTube a lot of dumb shit like that. I've been YouTubing how to use shit on the Instapot because when Mies got one, we got an Instapot and I'm like, you can make sinigang. You can make a adobo.
That shit is
the best. Hey, Phil made oxtail kare out of the Instapot.
In about like half an hour.
Call out your fucking boy. Half an hour.
Well, sorry, Gus, but that was no big secret the way you...
Yeah, I was expecting like something new.
I was going to eat it like a cartoon character.
Very.
I thought you were going to suck that thing dry.
Anticlimactic. Hey, do you eat the cartilage on the end of the
thing? I eat everything on that
really?
Motherfucker. Hell yeah.
You lick that bone clean. You lick that bone clean. It's whistling.
This is good.
Hey, episode 50. Hey, I want to do a shout out to the boy Lorenzo. Lorenzo's a dude that I worked with at my old at the job at my old position, and every time we would just talk during work, my dude would be like, "This is a podcast." He drilled that into me every time he said it, and then that's when I you know what I mean?
I like the idea.
I hit you. I hit Mono.
And now we're here.
We should have him on.
I want to have him on. I hit him all the time because he's the one that put me on. Like when I did real podcast like homework about how to listen to with a format of what people talked about.
Yeah.
Like he was like, check this one out. Check this one out. And I was like, you a fucking nerd. I was like, Lorenzo, you nerd motherfucker. But that's my ace though. So shout out to Zoe. I'm gonna have him on, and his brother actually was a background singer for Justin Bieber. So I'm trying to bring
like
bring
when he dude first on. Started or
yeah. Like baby like baby ooh oh. Baby baby ooh era, but that's still,
I was
that's
about
still
to sing
Justin
it,
Bieber baby. Money, that's still.
He was a backup singer.
He was there was a group
like
of them,
like on tour,
and they're all Filipino.
They went on tour with
him. So that's why I'm trying to I'm gonna get him on the pod and
I got a lot of questions for him.
Hey, you feel me?
Ooh, there you go. That's the secret right there. Damn. Easy. Hey, what the chicken wing do to you?
Yeah. Motherfucker fantastic. Yeah. All of it, honey. The cartilage, all of it.
Yeah, you got that all in one. One fail swoop right there. So what, after the 50 episodes, right? This is our 50th.
Mm-hmm.
What can you say is your most, I guess you can't say favorite, right? But one that sticks out the most.
Sounds stupid, but the one where thank you, the one where Gene came and Jared was there.
Oh,
and,
yeah.
And y'all talked about Boston.
Yeah, that was one of your favorites.
Yeah, it was funny. That one was funny because we talked about ghosts.
Yeah,
you remember that? We started talking about ghosts. Everyone's like, Jared had his experience in South City. You talk about your experience, yeah. And even like the Uber ride. But that was funny to me. I was like, you know, all those are probably private right now.
No.
Yeah,
no, those weren't.
Mm. Now they are, I think. You gotta earn those first 10.
The first 10.
that was a real work in progress.
I'm gonna say that was at least like.
That was men at work.
In the teens?
Was it? Probably.
Or 20s, probably. Maybe?
Probably.
Because that wasn't too long ago.
Yeah.
It's getting hot. All that habanero sauce got me all hot.
Which is your favorite dipping sauce out of the three?
I'm gonna go with the orange habanero.
Orange habanero. They gave us a tub of that, too. That's
pretty good.
Yeah, orange habanero.
The was it spicy garlic?
Yeah,
that's pretty good.
Like for me, dipping, I don't like to me. Everything's about the wing, the pure, just the wing. Cause I can eat that.
So you're about
rice.
The dry rub.
Mm-hmm. Rub it dry.
Chafing.
However you get it, you get it. I'll take what I can at this time. However you get it, you get it.
Help your boy out, Mish.
All right, shut up. Hey, I have one. If you had to get rid of one forever, and you can never be on it forever, would it be Netflix or YouTube?
Forever?
Ever.
You gotta get rid of Netflix.
Really?
Yeah.
I think I get rid of YouTube. Oh.
Really?
I rarely watch YouTube. Yeah. Unless I'm like trying to fix shit at the house.
YouTube, I can bring up a music video and watch it. Cause I remember that before, back in the days, you had to wait to see. Yeah. Oh, hey, look, the video's on, or Master P video's on, or you know, whatever we
gotta be Master P.
Cause it was the Let's Ride with
Montel Jordan.
Yeah, and Sense the Shocker. Hey, Master P. I be saying this, but apparently one of his daughters is half Filipino.
Really? I believe it.
Do you know that, Mono?
I believe it because he lived in the Bay Area.
Yeah.
No, well, he lived, right?
Yeah, lived in the Bay Area.
Hey, he stayed on JT the Bigger Figure's couch.
Hey, do you know about those Magnatis? Do you know what Magnatis are?
What's that?
Master P got his own shoe that's handcrafted in Italy. That's called Magnatis.
Are you serious?
It's spelled money and then ETTI. Magnati.
Master, like now?
Yeah, now. He's pushing them. I follow P. I rock with Master P. Yeah, no, like he did that.
I just had the playlist playing on the way over here.
You did? No, you did. Yeah, Master P did that.
Did you look it up? Is that it right there?
Yeah, Magnatis.
Not my flavor.
No, yeah. It's not. But
if he sponsored us, I'd wear it.
Right there. Yeah, Magnati, everything.
I'd wear that around my neck.
We had to do the podcast from the floor. Everyone's sitting like Chris. Hey, I say this and I don't realize that it's not a accepted term, but I said Indian style. But then the way they are taught to say it now is crisscross applesauce, right?
Is it really?
Yeah, crisscross applesauce.
Who taught you this?
I'm just saying, man, can't go to public school.
Yeah, man, so crisscross,
like they don't say Indian.
I didn't even trip
style.
All of that. Because the kids, yeah, they say crisscross applesauce.
Remember that song? What? One little, two little, three little. Like, is that people throwing shade and teaching it to the youth?
I don't know. Like, I get it. Then I also feel like people are a little bit too sensitive about stuff.
That sensitive? You can't call it Indian style?
It's
fucking dolls and fucking warped across the screen like that, right?
Yeah.
Come on.
You have to lock the Street Fighter to do that. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know.
So you see the schools are teaching our kids that these days?
Well, that's what it's not referred to. Well, ask Joey. Or
when I hear them, I hear crisscross
applesauce, right? It's not Indian.
I never tripped like they weren't saying Indian style. Mm. Like we used to be like, sit on the carpet for story time, sit Indian style. Yeah.
Don't sit next to him because he pees. Gus pees. Y'all remember the time y'all peed in school? No.
Nah, dog. In the toilet, yeah. Yeah.
What, you? Did you?
No.
I think we have a story here.
No.
Content.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. So you peed Indian style.
Crisscross. Or that's the wet part of the carpet. Like, you see the stain from the kid that peed there last? It's a white carpet. Like, that's a stain.
I didn't have people that peed in my class.
That'd be traumatizing. Potty training a kid is some of the most... that really tests your patience on potty training.
I don't even remember potty training.
Because you probably didn't do this shit.
No, like, I feel like he just, you know, did it. You take him into the bathroom. We put the little potty training toilet next to the real toilet.
And did he follow that?
And he just,
He just did it.
Converted it. We took away the small one day, and he just started going in the one and only one that was there.
That's that. But then also that stage of wearing, he's not wearing diapers in bed because he may, you know what I mean? Yeah.
It took the girls like...
Everyone's different.
Maybe like a few times in bed. Like maybe like two or three times where they peed in the bed and then they finally got it.
Yeah.
It wasn't like...
Well, if he pees, he sleeps next to me, so... Papa stayed dry, but that means I have to get up.
Yeah.
You got one of those special layers under your sheet? It's like a plastic layer?
Roll over, it's like...
At one point, we put like an extra... We put a blanket under Mikey's spot just in case. Like, he never really did it.
But yeah, you gotta be ready.
You know what
it,
I mean?
Yeah.
Like, just to catch it so it don't hit the mattress.
Yeah. Because once it hits the mattress, that's it.
Wow.
Stain City.
Yeah, dude. Hey, how often are you supposed to buy a bed? Like, is it every 10 years?
Like a mattress?
Yeah.
I just bought one like last year.
Hey.
And before that, it was a good fucking 10 years.
Yeah. I'm cheap, like. I bet, do we really need it?
I bet you cried when you gave your mattress away.
No, because it was a source of my back pain.
It was like memories.
There was a lot of history on that
going
thing.
Going down the drain. I like to keep stepping.
You looked at your son like you were conceived on that. <money.
laughs> And you flip it over and you're like, oh shit, there's a whole other story on there.
Like, no, that's the other 5 years of my life.
There goes all your brothers and sisters still laying there.
Do you actually have a bed or is your shit on the floor?
What do you mean? No, it's a box spring and bed and frame and all that.
Look at you, grown up.
Hey, that's new though, huh?
I had it for about, ever since I moved here.
Okay. So,
about
10, 11
years.
But before in the rich, it was on the floor?
It was a futon.
Hey, you had a futon.
I had a futon.
It was a futon. I would put a regular mattress on the futon frame.
Damn.
Boot up.
That's what happens when you're single. You do dumb shit like that.
Yeah, and a kid.
It just don't stop.
You don't think about stuff like that.
Yeah. Boot up. Yeah. Think about bed. And then you see how expensive a bed is?
Fuck, dude.
What? 2 racks?
Everybody's saying go with the sleep number.
I'm not mad at those.
But it's like at least 10 grand.
Okay, well, trip off this. Someone told me this, and this always rung true to me. You either spend time on your back or on your feet. Yep. So your shoes gotta be right, uh-huh. Your back gotta be right.
Yep.
My back's never right.
Whoa. Never?
No. It's just.
Do you stretch? That's some old man talk. You stretch in the morning?
I don't, dude. The most I stretch, like.
Hey, but Trip, dude, you work out, so you should be stretching.
I don't.
No, oh, I think it's because you work out, you don't need to stretch.
No, is that what you actually got to stretch more because he's using his muscles more than some like me.
There's one time I was at a when I was still doing Evolve. And then
shout out to Evolve, you want to sponsor
Evolve
us.
Training, yeah.
ASK free night.
I got some kids that are ready to take some classes, you know, to sponsor my classes.
We can evolve, and this could be yeah. Karate belts instead of chicken and noodles. But yeah, today is chicken
boxing
and noodles.
Gloves right here.
You feel me?
Let me throw this. But drumstick. We did a class where it was straight up just stretching.
Just stretching?
And I was sweating my ass off just stretching.
It's like yoga.
That shit hurt.
Hey, so on the stretching shit. Like there's most people say people don't breathe enough in their life and they don't stretch enough.
And people don't drink enough water.
Yeah, I know. I drink hella fucking water. But then I'll be sitting there and I stretch and everything pops. Like you ever do those stretches?
Yeah.
Man.
That's why I like stretching.
You like stretching?
I don't like stretching.
But you need to though. You really out here.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, no.
You healthy dude here. All that chicken. No, but Schlottmann. Shout out to Schlottmann. That's just good chicken.
I want to drink every night.
You drink every night?
At least a glass. Like what you're holding right now, you one a night.
I'm going to go with at least two.
That's heavy. Why you got to give us the clear things where everyone knows what we're sipping on?
It's all
right. I'm sorry. We bought those and I just wanted to share.
What about you, Gus? You drink every night?
No, I don't drink every night.
Like only when we're here? Once a week?
Yeah. Here. Like I'll be at Phil's house sometimes and he's like, you want to drink? I was like, no, I don't. It's never been my like.
You want a flat?
Yeah. You want to suck down this flat?
Take a drumstick. You want to see me open? You want to see me crack this Da Vinci Code open? I acted like I had the cure for cancer.
I know. I thought you was going to show us something new. He was like, you just break it.
I was like, that's
fuck,
it?
That's it?
That's it. Just,
you got to eat
damn,
that.
Damn, dog.
You don't know how many years I ate that shit whole like that.
Did you? And you're the motherfucker that left all the meat on there, huh? Oh, dude, I hate that.
Sitting there tonguing through the middle part like, blah, blah, blah.
Oh, there's still more meat. Blah, 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 blah.
Sitting there. I'm trying to suck the shit off. It's not even crispy anymore.
So you were the one that wasted all the meat. Flats.
Hey, I used to be told, you don't know how to eat fried chicken.
Oh, man.
Hey, you got a special way to eat fried shrimp or like boiling crab shrimp?
I gotta use my hands and I can't use gloves.
Oh really?
No.
Wait, to peel it?
Yeah, a special way to peel it.
I reap it. I rip the legs off first.
Legs first.
Yeah.
The shells.
And then the shell.
Like do you scale it? Like do you peel one scale at the head and then the whole thing comes off, or do you peel each scale at once? Or
you know
what I'm saying? Yeah. That, okay. Like that skill. Yeah. Like
usually if you like break it at the top.
Yeah.
And then the whole thing will just come apart
as one piece.
No, yeah. I'm real native with my shit. Like I'll grab the shit. I just
put the shell.
I just crunch all the way through.
He just chews it. He just chews it like fuck it, it's good.
Oh, it's like a hot pocket. I just crunch through. You know what I do though is like I separate the head from the body and I suck their brains out. The
you look like a brain sucker.
No, I think there's a lot of people out there that they when they go to eat shrimp like that, they don't know how to do it properly.
Mm. Well, it depends. Does the shrimp come with the head on or with the head
off? Like, say, crab.
I always get head on.
Yeah. Ah. Like, out the bag. Out the, you know.
Yeah, you got to break the head off first.
Yeah.
You can't have any, like, cuts on your hands. Like, no paper cuts.
Cause twist off the head. Suck it out.
Yeah, suck the head.
Suck the brains
and then,
out.
And then legs
we're talking
off.
About eating shrimp.
And legs off.
Legs yeah. off,
and then you stretch the shrimp. You straighten the shrimp, and then get that scale and bop.
No, I try to take it as soon as I take the legs off. I just try to like clean it because depending how good they boiled it, it should just peel right off.
So
like
you grab the head scale or the tail scale, like which
I grab from
you...
the side of the body. So what I do, like you said, I take the tails off.
We
and
need
I
to
just,
find a shrimp sponsor.
Yeah,
I just next episode. I just peel that shit.
We're gonna
like,
need to see a demonstration, Gus.
Yeah. This is how we
hopefully
chicken.
It's better than me.
We ate at this Thai spot in Vegas. Lotus of Siam.
Jack Talk Thai.
Dude, they have these fucking prawns. It's I don't know if they like air fry it, deep fry it, but you could eat the shell too, the skin.
They probably soak it. They probably soak it so it gets the shell.
That shit's
soft.
So motherfucking good.
Because the only time to eat fried shrimps, the shell is when it's fried, like oil deep fried.
Like that Filipino style shit. Yeah.
Like air fried, I don't know if it's still edible.
I don't think so.
I don't want my air fry smelling like shrimp.
Yeah. Air fry is not the same. So it had to be deep fried.
Yeah, I'm sure. That motherfucking good. Yeah.
Really? At that Thai spot?
What's the place called?
Lotus of Siam?
Siam.
What? Dude. Every time every time we're there, we gotta go there. It's off the strip.
How far is the strip?
Maybe like a 5-minute Uber ride. It's not that far off the strip.
That's not bad. No, yeah. Lotus good. Siam.
Siam. Yeah, that's
Siam. Siam.
They never have reservations.
That's it, Phil.
Really? You just walk. That's it. Just walk in, huh?
Well, if you could get a reservation, get in there. But if not, you just get there when they open.
620 East.
Flamingo, right?
East 620 East Flamingo Road, Las Vegas, Nevada 89119.
Man,
all right. I have a question.
Okay,
everything. I think everything we had there. I want to go back just to order more shit.
Did you get fish? Did you get any curries?
We had a curry.
I
don't even know what else we had. Shit, everything we had was good.
I don't know how to order shit there. I have to look at what the... You know how, like, I know what larb is? That's, like, pretty much ground beef, right?
Yeah.
That's torta.
Ground pork or
without
something?
The egg, right? Yeah. Torta without the
so
egg.
So what were you going to say? You had a question?
Oh, yeah. Well, just random shit.
Uh-oh.
So, if you have to get rid of one, right? You have to get rid of one. Would it be Beyonce, Whitney Houston, Mariah Carey, or Janet Jackson? I want to hear from Mono.
Beyonce.
Really?
I would get rid of Beyonce. Just personally, the only track I really like I would go to and go type into my phone and slap is Me, Myself, and I. One. But if you all the other artists you name, I could type in at least 4 or 5 songs that I would actually go into.
You're lying. Because
my
girlfriend was playing when we walked in.
That's a Jay-Z song.
Jay-Z.
That's a Jay-Z song, not a Beyonce.
Crazy right now.
I'm a single lady. I'm a single lady.
That's what Gus bumps in the shower.
We had a Beyonce song on our
your mix CD.
The wedding
album.
Wedding day.
Did you get
game
one?
Day.
Yeah, game day.
Game day. Soulmates.
That's still in my car. I think that's still in my CD changer.
Hanging from your rearview mirror.
Oh shit, that's of culture.
Wait, who would you get rid of? Who would you get rid of?
Yeah, what's the choices?
So
yeah.
It would be Beyonce, Whitney Houston, Mariah Carey, or Janet Jackson.
I think
I got mine.
I think I would go with Beyonce, too.
Yeah. Yeah. Really?
I wanted to say Mariah Carey, but, you know, no. Mariah Carey.
Think of her remixes.
You know, with Boyz II Men. You know what I mean?
One Sweet Day.
Yeah, that. And then, you know.
Bone.
Yeah.
Bone Thugs.
I'll Be Home with
ODB.
And then her Christmas songs.
Fire.
You know what I mean?
Oh, God. Let that play on Christmas. You know? Jesus.
Mariah Carey all day. Jesus. Christmas.
Really?
MC.
Yeah. Janet Jackson. Come on, man. Rhythm Nation.
Yeah. Yeah.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
All that.
Yeah.
And then Whitney Houston. Come on, it's Whitney Houston.
Yeah.
You can't get rid of Whitney Houston. Sorry, Beyonce.
Mm-hmm. Mariah would be probably Mariah.
Be yours?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, Mariah.
Bah humbug.
Yeah.
Mariah. Scrooge over here. Sorry. Scrooge.
Sorry, Nick Cannon. Shout out to Nick.
Scrooge over here.
Yeah, I'm just saying. Wow. Hey.
Come
hey,
on. Beyonce doesn't. She do no Christmas songs.
Well, what's the best song from Mariah Carey? This is how I judge. Let me tell you guys how I judge an artist.
And it can't be collab.
No, yeah. This is the best smash hit.
That's their own.
Yeah. Mariah Carey, what's her smash hit?
See. What was her first song?
ODB? You got me feeling emotion.
Okay, and then you think of, okay, so think of it like this. That song, Emotion, what other artist could have done that song better than her? Same writer, same beat.
It was the yelling that did the song. Like her as an artist, yeah. she
could reach that note.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know.
What other artists? You know what I'm saying?
Like Beyonce is good.
Lizzo.
I'm so sick of that.
I'm just saying so she can hit that. I'm not saying.
Yeah.
You said she can hit that.
Every time I hear her song on
with
the radio,
a flute,
like, that's how I judge music. Like what if when you hear a song, what other artists could have killed it more than this?
Lizzo could do
it.
And
the other day, hey, no lie, the other day it was on the radio. It was the Celine Dion Titanic song was on, right?
Ooh.
And I was like,
I like the Cha Cha remix.
And then, and then you think, what other artist could have killed it? And honestly, I think Whitney Houston would have killed that harder than
Celine.
Than Celine.
If they would have gave it the color,
imagine that.
Yeah. But it was Titanic, so they can't.
No, yeah. They couldn't. They had to play the audience.
The note she hit in the Bodyguard soundtrack, put that on that Titanic, she would have killed it.
Yeah. Whitney would have
murdered. Bodyguard soundtrack was
okay. The soundtrack. Out of that four, then who's number one out of that bunch? Who's number one out of that bunch?
You can't.
No, you have to.
I'm gonna go. I'm gonna say Whitney Houston.
That might be. The most correct answer.
Yeah,
the
Whitney.
For number one?
It's not Mariah Carey.
So the choices are Beyonce, Whitney, Mariah, and Janet Jackson.
I'd say number one, Whitney.
And then
Whitney,
Janet. Whitney, Janet. I put Beyonce last.
I think I would put Beyonce above.
Beehive?
Over Whitney?
Mariah Carey.
Okay, maybe.
Mariah Carey.
No, not for me.
Okay, what's your order then?
It would be a tie between Whitney and Janet.
Number one?
And then a tie between Mariah and Beyonce. Well,
you can't go with a tie.
Yeah, no
tie.
Number one, it'd probably be Janet.
Janet Jackson.
Ooh,
Janet.
Over Whitney?
Oh, just because the Jackson family is just fire. Right?
But okay.
But that's just a family.
What song then? What Janet song did it for you?
Fuck, man. I was actually bumping the Rhythm Nation album, and there's a lot of fucking fire on that.
That's if.
Yeah.
That's if. That was that Rhythm Nation?
I think so. No.
If I was your girl,
Rhythm Nation's older.
No.
That was newer. That was Janet.
Yeah, that's Janet.
Yeah.
Look at Mono with the Janet history. Rhythm Nation was Rhythm Nation.
Yeah.
Hey, can we get a Janet Jackson on the next We Eating episode? We Eating Radio?
Something?
Yeah.
Something new? I was knocking on the way here. I get in my schmood, but playing your Spotify, We Eating Radio. So Janet would be your number one, and then?
And then maybe Whitney.
Maybe Whitney?
And then Mariah, and then Beyonce.
Ooh, what about you? Top.
Whitney's number one.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Whitney's number one. She, okay.
Yeah, I agree.
She's number one.
Okay, number two.
Because she did it bald, too. Hey, she came out. Hey, right? She rocked it. She rocked it. Yeah. She rocked it bald. All right. And then number two.
With drugs.
Number two. Yeah. She was a hood chick, though. That's why. Yeah.
After Bobby, though.
No, I heard she's always been hood.
Really?
I heard she's always been. No? But the image they had to provide to sell her to the audience had to be clean.
So when she got with Bobby, that was her natural.
It was just, she was just being her. Hey, just fact check me.
Google sorry, shit. Sorry, Bobby, I blamed you.
And then, so it'd be Whitney, and then it'd be a toss up between, you know, Beyonce, because she did it.
Number two?
Yeah. Yeah. And then it would be Janet, then Mariah.
Whitney's from New Jersey.
She's hood.
She's from New Jersey, yeah.
Yeah.
Joyzy.
Yeah.
She just, okay. She just was young in the shit. Like, Janet Jackson comes from that family, though, so it's not like.
But it's that family.
Yeah, though. But see, it ain't. She ain't Michael.
Janet's from Indiana.
Yeah, she's from, what's that place called?
It's called
Gary. Yeah, but Gary.
It's Janet Jackson, though.
It is Janet Jackson. She was with Jermaine Dupri.
She got kind of fat.
It's all right. Well, hey. She had a surrogate. You think she had a surrogate? That's always been the conversation.
Really? Wait, she has a kid?
She has a kid.
Since when?
That's what they said about Beyonce, too.
Yeah.
They did say that.
Like she was never pregnant, and she was pregnant on one of those TV shows.
And then an award show.
The pillow went to the side.
And there was what? Nothing? You're lying.
No, it was on one of those morning talk shows where
The View?
She stuffed the pillow, and then it kind of went... It went lopsided, and she forgot to fix it for hella long, and everyone was just like, oh, that's a fake fucking pregnancy, and like the pillow was literally on her hip.
Like, if you're that rich, wouldn't you just use something else other than a pillow?
Yeah. Right?
Or it wasn't the right dress for the pillow. You know, if right? Maybe she tried to wear something tight, because pregnant women still do that. They still try to show off the...
Yeah.
Their curves?
Yeah, curvatios.
Curvatio.
Pastor Gavassier.
That was a good one. I like that one. Yeah. What else you got?
Stick to that phone, Gus.
I think I got some. What would you rather?
That was a. I don't know, but see, Mariah's okay. Mariah's okay.
I think the thing that saves Mariah is her
Christmas songs,
her Christmas album, Timeless. And then her collabs with her MTV, ODB.
God, those are fire.
Her MTV Cribs.
In the bathtub. In the
bathtub.
I don't remember that.
Just kidding. Well, I'm just saying, like, you know, I don't know. Beyonce's a vibe.
Beyonce, well, I say
vibe.
Better not mess with a beehive.
She's been the queen. She's been the queen of R&B for the last 10. Was it say 10 years?
It's a 15 vibe. Years.
But so before Beyonce, who was the queen of R&B?
Lizzo.
Before. You like her? I really like her movement, but I don't like her songs.
You don't like how she moves?
Is that her hella skinny now?
No.
She got skinny?
Lizzo?
No.
She's on the Tiny Desk. You ever watch those Tiny Desk?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I heard what you're talking about.
Those are funny. She's out there sweating.
Why is she on a Tiny Desk?
Oh, everything looks tiny around me. Would you rather? So Netflix, you said Netflix over
YouTube?
Over YouTube?
You know what it is? Because like a lot of people put dumbass shit on YouTube.
But it's endless.
But everything you find on Netflix, you can find it on YouTube.
Okay, let's say this. Netflix at its most fire moment or YouTube at its most fire moment?
YouTube.
Probably YouTube.
You can find everything on YouTube.
Yeah,
that's music true. Videos,
I'm watching
songs.
Ozark on Netflix right now. I could find it on YouTube.
You probably
can. Why did you pay for Netflix then if you could find it on YouTube?
Because I want to watch it.
I want to watch it right now.
Because everything else.
Did you buy it on Black Friday? Oh, no,
I just bought it like 30 minutes ago.
Mishka.
Just so he could start the new episode again.
Hey, I walked in, you're hella smiling to yourself. I looked at the screen, all I see was titties, and I was like, show. Oh, okay.
It's a good show, Gus. You
Ozark.
Should watch it.
Ozark, that's a, yeah, that's good.
I can't watch it.
And it's from 2018, so I'm late.
2000 and late.
Hey, I fall asleep as soon as I get in the bed.
I watch that shit at work.
See, I don't have time to watch it at work. You over there on the...
Hey, you know...
Catching wood in the truck, in the work truck. Catching wood in the work truck. Oh, man, I got to go somewhere with this.
I got a coworker that I caught him watching porn in his truck. I was like, really, dude? You can't... He's over there, hey, check this out. I'm like, no, dude, it's not cool, bro. Yeah.
I can't watch, like... Watching porn as a unit, like
there's no team in porn, man.
I don't like having the same thought y'all are having at the same time.
Yeah. Hey, dog. Yeah, look at that. Woo! High five me. No, don't high five me.
Out of here.
Your hands sticky.
I'm out of here, yo.
Yeah, that dude's just a little off. He's a little off.
We all a little different. We all a little different.
So you want a would you rather question? Yeah. I found it.
Let's do it. Would
this
you
was
rather.
From like weeks. Okay.
Would you rather
get caught watching porn?
Oh shit.
Or get caught practicing sex positions with a pillow?
Watching porn. Hmm. That's easy.
What if you were in the act of watching porn? Like you were just straight going at it.
That's
so you're saying watching porn and
jacking off. Jacking off.
In the moment.
Are we humping the pillow naked?
Or humping the pillow. Or is it dry humping the pillow?
Is it dry humping?
Are you dry humping?
Through the boxers.
Let's
only if they're silk.
Let's go just through the boxers, like pants off.
Pillow.
He said that with confidence. Pillow.
But it's the same pillow you sleep with every night. Ooh. Like that's your face pillow.
No, it's the decoration pillow on the couch. The one everybody grabs when they sit down and watch TV.
That's the one with the dimple. With the dimple in it.
Yeah. It's like saying, would you rather have someone walk in with you wearing boxers or walking with you butt naked? I pick boxers. Pump in a pillow.
I'd probably pick butt naked.
But hard though. But
because I could be like, that's what you get for looking.
it's not like a dry hump, but you're really in the moment. Like you have headphones on. And you're watching this shit on your phone and you have headphones on. okay, what about this? Would you rather get busted? Okay. Jacking off at work?
Damn.
Or with a fleshlight at the house.
Well, who busts you at the house?
Yeah, who's
wife and kids.
Ooh. Shit. I'd rather get busted at work. I don't want to have to explain that to my kids.
I'll take it to the house.
Okay. Take it to the house?
Yeah.
So
fleshlight at the house.
Fleshlight at the house?
Yeah.
And your son be like, what the fuck are you doing, Dad?
I want to walk into work tomorrow. Like, hey, guys. What's up?
But at the same time, like, I don't care what anybody thinks.
You on the bus?
What if I walk into my house and explain to my kid, like, it's all right. You came at my nuts.
Yeah. That's true. Your brothers and sisters are all over my mattress
that I threw out. This is how you were made.
Yeah. You're the lucky one. You made it off my mattress.
You survived.
Yeah.
You walk into work. You walk into your cubicle. You stick your head up around the cubicle. You're like, oh, shit, all these motherfuckers see me.
Hi. What about you?
I don't know.
It better be home. Fleshlight.
It'd probably be at the house.
I don't care at work. I don't give a shit what people, you know.
The work common area though.
I don't give a shit.
Like, or at the work Christmas party, and then, behind the big Christmas tree. You know?
Those Christmas parties get wild.
I can't imagine.
I remember DJing Christmas parties.
Yeah.
And watching people and be like, there's going to be a lot of explaining to do come Monday morning.
Do you remember that one we did at
AT&T
Park? AT&T
Park?
Yeah. Yeah, that one was popping.
There was a lot of shit going on.
There was a lot of work.
Christmas parties is when a lot of people fuck around.
Yeah. Yeah, when people from work get like...
Get drunk.
They get their tensions out. Yeah. My wife's always at my Christmas party.
Yeah.
So what are you trying to say?
Nothing ever happens. I'm not the one. Gus ain't the one.
Don't even try it, girl.
Yep. You better stop. My girl gonna beat you up.
Yeah. I know you want this.
I'm one of those. You better stop. My girl's gonna beat you up and me up when I get to the house. You better fucking stop.
Yeah. If I get in trouble, I'm gonna beat you up too.
Yeah. Do you guys have that designated girl that if something happens with another girl, that you want and you to beat this bitch up? Do you got something like that?
Yeah. No. The beater upper?
Everyone has the girl that...
I don't have a beater up.
Yeah, you do. Yours is probably Rach.
If something went down...
Yeah, it's probably my cousin, yeah. Shout out to Rach.
If something went down, you know exactly who to call.
So if one girl tried to do you dirty and you couldn't do nothing to her, but you got a... I got a couple. I got a couple, like... I know Linlin would get down.
Stay right here.
Yeah.
Somebody right here. Fuck you up.
I know Meech would get down.
Right there. Has Meech ever got into a fight?
Nah, but...
She seemed too nice. But she, I think she would. I think she would fuck somebody up.
Those are the ones you got.
You see that twinkle in her eye, like she fuck somebody up. Yeah.
Tybo, bro.
Billy Blanks on your ass. Show ass.
You feel me? Seeing stars out here. Should do like the
give you a one, two.
Shit. Kwando your ass.
Kwando. Let me see if I got another. What would you rather?
Yeah, I think. Okay. The shit at home you can always bounce back from.
Okay, here goes.
Uh oh. Would you rather?
Would you rather have your mom or dad catch you masturbating? Mm. Or would you rather you catch your mom and dad masturbating?
Oh.
Gross.
Y'all ever get, okay.
Either way, I'd fucking poke my eyes out.
Would you, did you ever get walked in on?
No. I don't think so.
You're lying.
I don't think so.
The way you're shaking your head, Mono, you got your head tilted. No, you're looking up at the sky. No, like, nope.
I'm trying to remember. Like,
unless they didn't say anything to me and I thought I was slick.
No. Oh my God.
No?
Yeah.
You what? Got caught? Mom, you got caught?
Mom's walked in and she goes, what are you doing? I was like, close the door! Close the door!
What are you doing?
Nothing! Close
I'm
the door!
I'm rolling dice!
This pillow, the stuffing is. Close the door!
Why'd you have to get satin pillows, Mom?
Oh my God. Yeah? No.
So
no.
You would rather have them catch you rather you catch them?
That's it. Even though I know that's where I birthed from, that's an image I can't get out.
Yeah,
it's
gross.
Yeah, Pops walked in on me once, and I don't care.
Dude, you got caught hella times. Mom's caught you. Pops caught you. Well,
he doesn't have a lock on the door.
You might want to wait till they leave next time.
Hey, you ever chill at the house and then thing is all good, and then someone come over and knock on the door, and you're like, so sexy.
What?
Wait for the time to pass. I'm sleeping.
Maybe I just don't answer the door. They'll just go away.
Just chill.
Yeah.
I gotta pee. I like it's just real quick. Just hold it real quick. Let the moment pass.
Oh wait, what are you talking about?
Nothing.
You need a minute. That conversation.
You got real personal.
Yeah. Who was there with you?
To Slap Ma. I'm saying, man, my people's out there.
Shout out to this pickled cabbage right here.
How was that, Corquito?
Shit, hella good, man. Look.
Yeah, the drumsticks. Don't be fooled by the drumsticks. This is a secret menu.
This
shit.
This is like Balutan right here.
Yeah, that's homie shit. Secret menu. Maybe you get right. But so support those small businesses. What'd you think of the sauce on the white rice?
This one?
Yeah.
That was good.
The Filipino friend. That's called the Filipino friend.
There's hella fucking garlic in
yeah,
there.
Yeah, no, he get down. Air fryer. This should be perfect.
Wait, are you saying these wings are air fried?
No.
Oh.
No, they gotta be deep fried.
Yeah, no,
this is too good.
Yeah, he has.
You can't get that crisp on an air fryer.
But to bring these back to life, like that turbo I got at the house, New Wave. Shout out to New Wave. You want to sponsor us?
New Wave is an air fryer.
New Wave. It's a set it and forget it. It's a New Wave oven.
Yeah,
I'll bring that shit over next time.
It's different from an air fryer.
It's not. It's more like a turbo.
You got an air fryer?
Turbo.
I do got an air fryer.
You just got an air fryer.
What do you air fry?
Dude, I air fry everything.
You like if you had chicken, you put these back in just to get them right, yeah. Right?
Yeah. I do my own salt and vinegar wings in the air fryer.
Safeway, is that the Safeway salt and vinegar ring?
You use that as a source of cooking or just a source of reheating?
I do both.
We got the one, my wife got me one where it's like
shout out to Jane.
It's like an air fryer plus it's like, dude, it's like a little oven.
Yeah.
Mm. So you don't gotta heat up the whole fucking oven. But it has an air fryer
component.
Yeah, whatever.
I had some air fried lumpia. It was trash.
No, yeah, because you need the oil. You need the oil to crisp out.
Like, what's good out of an air fryer?
Those Dino nuggets from Costco. Mike,
French fries. You can do French fries in there.
Raw potato.
Sweet potato fries. I do this marinade. This is my like my Filipino version of like chicken marinade. So I do soy sauce. I do what is that? Banana ketchup. Depending who's having it, I use the regular one. What else? I use onion, garlic, Coke. Coca-Cola. What? Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola or 7-Up, depending who.
What are you pitting, Mikey?
And then brown sugar. Let that shit sit for like 2 days.
Yeah.
Throw that shit in the air fryer.
Mm-hmm. All right, next time I'll bring my salt and vinegar wings.
All right.
In the air fryer.
I'll bring the new wave and we'll do a cook off.
Like, you cook your shit, I'll cook my shit. You know what I mean? Have a little chicken.
Yeah, because I ain't never had nothing good out of a fucking air fryer. That's why
I'm who's making. Like, I can make a good tri-tip out of a, or a good,
In the air fryer? Or in the New Wave?
New Wave, yeah. New Wave. New Wave is shit. I wouldn't do an air fryer. I got an Instapot. We'll try to figure out recipes for
that. The air fryer is kind of tricky. You got to be careful of, like, what you do. Because you can't do, like, regular-ass shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, yeah, it all depends on how you cook, like what you use to cook it. Because I tried doing like a tequila lime, but I think it was too much sugar.
Did you put the actual tequila on it? I think it's the alcohol that's on it. That
because it's a sugar, it doesn't.
Yeah, it don't grab,
no,
right?
No.
Yeah.
No.
Like the
but tequila. That's why the salt and vinegar is like the only one that I really like.
How do you prep that? Salt and vinegar chicken wings.
I just marinate in salt and vinegar
overnight
and then just air fry it.
Does it get crispy still?
Yep.
Because the one,
I mean, it doesn't get as crispy as a deep fried,
yeah,
but it still comes out pretty crispy. I think if I try to maybe batter it up like with some flour, it might, but I mean, you know what I mean, you're not gonna get that like that deep fry.
No, you never get that deep fried. Yeah. But air fryer, yeah. Like,
cause it just doesn't get hot enough.
Yeah, for the new wave oven, not the air fryer. You could do a good like pork belly, but make it to where you're getting the belly crisp. You know what I mean? The skin crisp.
So when I do my pork belly, I put it in the oven.
Yeah.
And then for like the last 10 minutes, I'll just put on broil. That way, you get the skin.
Is that right?
Somewhat crispy. Yeah.
New wave oven mono is the shit.
I'm trying to figure out the difference between an air fryer and a new wave.
Air fryer,
like the way you guys are talking about the food, I'm like, what the fuck is the fucking difference?
It's different.
Yeah.
Like my shit is not an air, you know, it, like honestly, the new wave oven, whenever we go to Porto's,
it keeps the shit juicy.
It gets it, it brings it back to life.
Like, so it says new wave is more like, the shit's still juicy, but the air fryer is more crispy.
That's between the both, yeah, I'd probably say probably. Yeah,
that's right.
The crispiness is the difference.
You have to put oil right in a certain compartment in an air fryer. In an air fryer, right? You don't.
Air fryer is air, baby.
It's supposed to be healthier. You know what I mean? Yeah. Healthier. But yeah, you're not gonna get that deep fried crisp. You'll get a all right crisp off of it. But
sinigang or nalaga?
Sinigang, man. Okay. Come on.
See, it's all powder though.
Yeah, I love that powder.
It fucking tastes great.
Really. I love that powder.
My dad's nalaga slaps. Okay. Nalaga is like
your dad's adobo slaps.
Though. It's like a beef. The way my dad does it, it's a beef onion based soup. So it's like beef bone and onion based. What my dad, he puts a lot of marrow because you know
you gotta have that marrow.
That's where like a lot of the flavor is.
Yeah.
And he my dad's the first only dude I knew that used pressure cooker to keep. That's what he does to cook his his
pressure
beef.
Cookers are shit.
Pressure cookers. That's pretty much what a Instapot is. It's a pressure cooker. So I pressure cook the meat for like a couple hours to get that shit tender, and then on the side,
tenderoni.
He'll cook the soup in like a beef broth. So that'll be brewing, and as soon as it's ready, he just collaborates. He makes it a collaboration project and then slaps them all together, put the vegetables in for the last 15.
Collaborate and listen.
You know what I mean?
Salmon sinigang or pork spare rib?
Pork spare rib all day.
Yeah. I don't do a lot like I don't.
You ever had a good salmon?
I have. My dad get down with that.
Yeah.
I just can't.
It's a lot cleaner.
No.
But it is. It don't taste the same.
Yeah.
You don't have that heartiness of that pork. Yeah, dude.
Or you know what's whack to me? My dad makes it good, apparently everyone, but it's like adobo squid.
I love that shit.
I don't rock with
it. Oh, hey, bring me some of that next time he makes it, and I'll tell you if it's good or not.
Really? All right, yeah.
I fucking love that shit.
Yeah,
really?
I can't do it.
You eat dried? You eat dried squid?
No, that's too.
Mish does that.
It's a dried squid?
Hell yeah, you gotta be on a plane with that shit. Like,
stinking up the whole plane. Good job, Mish. Nobody's sitting next to you.
Come back with hello, Lihing. Hello, Lihing.
What's the worst Filipino food you just cannot eat?
Like restaurant?
Just food. No, food itself. Period. Just food you can't. Filipino food you cannot. Like, never.
I can't do balut.
Yeah, me too. I mean, I think that applies to a lot of people.
But it's not.
Though.
That's not terrible though.
Yeah,
I've never tasted it.
Bitter melon. I hate bitter melon.
Oh, I can't do bitter melon.
I can eat it now.
What?
It's good for your heart.
It's good. Yeah. That's how old man.
Tastes horrible.
My dad would try. Bitter melon. My dad would try to like spice it up with like egg and like ground turkey.
No, it's not good.
Ground pork with tomato.
What don't you like, guys?
I don't fuck with like.
You don't fuck with flats.
A double squid.
A double squid. I don't fuck with like.
Did it go on? You do did it go on?
Depends who makes it. Like, I'll eat it, but I won't hate it. I don't like what's that smelly fish? Do you?
Yeah, do you?
A lot
of people don't like that.
I just don't like the smell.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like there's a commitment with eating that shit. Like you can't be going to work, or you can't be cooking it when I'm going to work. You
That's
know what I mean?
A lot of shit though that you cook, you can't be. You know what I mean? Like,
but then I eat spam, and spam's terrible for you.
Hey, spam is good. Okay, spam is good.
What's the best off-brand spam? Not off-brand, but like you know how they have the spicy one, the teriyaki, the tocino spam.
The flavor, the best flavor.
Which is the best flavor?
The garlic one is the best.
Garlic,
really?
The garlic or the tocino?
I was gonna say tocino.
I like loso jam.
What?
What's that? But the loso jam.
But the tocino, it burns quicker.
It does.
Because of all the sugar on it.
You
gotta cook at lower heat. Yeah.
That Tabasco. Sorry. The Tabasco's not bad.
That was Tabasco? Not bad. Where did you get that?
They have it at Pacific Super. Yeah. You know what's the worst? Probably the oven turkey spam. The oven bake.
The fuck?
It comes out like white. The turkey spam?
Anything turkey's garbage.
Tocino is an ill flavor.
Fire.
Yeah, it's an ill flavor.
Yeah.
I never had the garlic one. I had.
I think I had
that one. You got to burn because there's like badass chunks of garlic in there.
A can of spam's like $4, so it's really not that cheap of food.
No, not no more. Unless you go to Costco, you get the low sodium one.
Then, yeah, that's all you get all one flavor. So jam.
So
how do you cook your spam?
Extra crispy.
Yeah, just on the fryer. On the pan.
On a pan?
That's it.
Oil fryer?
Yep. Yeah.
You put oil in it?
A tad of olive oil. Ooh, that's it.
I just fry it like that.
Yeah.
Because I figure all the oil comes off of it anyway.
Yeah.
I want that shit crispy.
This motherfucker. Mouth is watering.
Crispy.
I want
that's my son's shit.
Like, yeah, I like it crispy.
But sometimes I
don't have the patience for it, so I just take it off hella fast.
How many slices do you get out of one can of spam?
The lines that you see on the spam, I cut in between those lines.
There's lines on the can of spam?
Next time you empty out the spam on a cutting board and turn it on its side, you'll see lines. They're like they're like guidelines. I cut in between the lines. So I get a good line.
Have you seen the line?
9 to 11 pieces out of that.
9 to 11 pieces.
This is more counted.
Yeah, there's lines on the spam.
I just do two cans. Just
look at it next time
for the whole house, right?
Yeah, I have never seen the lines on there.
I like cutting them thin, so they're kind of crispy.
Yeah. So I don't like the thick ones.
Then you act like taco shells, and you can put rice in the middle and the egg and ketchup, and it's like
dude,
taco.
That's what my kids do. They fucking put the rice on it. I'm like, wow, that's very good. Eat that shit.
Hey.
Someone said to boil spam first.
What?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know. That's what I said. I was like, why? Because you're trying to get rid of all the fat shit.
Why would you boil it?
No, someone said to boil it first and then just do a quick fry.
What?
I've never tried it, but I mean, just
what nationality was this person?
I was Filipino.
Really?
But if you look at the OG spam covers, it looks like they baked the shit whole. And they would have
then they sliced it?
Yeah, they would have like pineapples and like cherries on top. You know what I'm talking about? Or you ever get those canned hams? My dad's all about that shit. Those.
Then the blue can?
Yeah.
Right?
And you got the turnkey.
Yeah.
That's like the OG corned beef.
That's fucking corn. Yeah. I was about to say
that was before honey baked.
Honey baked.
What's the best corned beef? Canned corned beef out
Ox there?
Hormel.
Hormel, Oxenpalm.
Those are two fire brands you guys just threw out there. because that one has the
skin, the meat flap.
Yeah.
The Oxenpalm has nice chunks of fat in it.
Yeah. My kids don't really like that, good. So I always got to peel it out.
Oh, you just got to fry it a little longer. That's it.
No, they see it. But the Hormel, I could make that shit nice and crispy.
Hormel is the one. But then, okay.
Just rice.
How do you prepare that? Because my wife's family makes it different than how
you're
my
supposed
family
to do it
makes
just
it.
Like you do spam. Put it on the pan and fry that bitch.
How do y'all do it?
We do it both. That and then with the cabbage and like kind of soupy.
My in-laws do it to where it's soupy. So it's like onions.
What do you mean, add broth?
No,
just like water,
a little water, just to water it down. So
with cabbage,
and tomatoes.
No cabbage in mine. Tomato and onions. That's how Misha's parents do it.
Tomatoes. You're Samoan, huh?
Possible.
God.
Hey.
Fa-a-a-uli.
Sounds like the Usos. Yeah, they boil it down and then like they eat it like soupy like that. The way I was,
it sounds good.
The way I was raised, my dad would chop up garlic, onions, tomato, no cabbage, and then he'll just stir fry that like bitch.
That? Yeah, I've had it both ways, where it's soupy and then where it's dry.
I'm alright with either
good.
Way.
They're both good.
It depends on my mood.
My body doesn't accept it anymore. Like no,
really?
Yeah, I can't.
Any corned beef?
Yeah, any corned beef. Like that shit is not the one. Like sometimes I'd be like, man, I. Sounds
good. You ever cut up the corned beef like Spam and fry it like that?
The Hormel one, yeah.
Yeah.
Hormel with it.
You can't do that with the other one.
Nah, either. You know what my dad does with either or? He would make it like a torta. Like he used egg. Like, so he'll chop up like potatoes, not like hash browns. He'll chop up potatoes.
I'm gonna take some of this right here.
He'll grill it all up. You know what I mean? He'll get the corned beef to where it's kind of crispy.
Yeah.
And then he'll just throw egg on top, and it'll be like a straight up corned beef torta.
Damn.
Hey, I'm not a small dude. You feel me?
Yeah. Not by accident.
Pops Wiggles.
This is not by accident.
Nah, you feel me?
He knew what he was doing.
You know what I mean? Shout out to Schlappmann. Shout out to Schlappmann. How many minutes we got in here?
We are at 105.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That was pretty fast. Any reflections on episode 50s, my brother?
So that's 50? What I'm saying. So your top one was...
Oh.
We got to find out what episode that was.
Yeah. I don't even... Well...
What number that was?
That one sticks out to me like... I couldn't tell you numbers, but there's always gonna be conversations. Yeah. Who I am thankful for is for everyone that ever came on and spent time with us.
Whoever
spent time, whoever took time out just to post with us and bullshit on the mic. You know what I mean? Like, it's all love. Everyone that listens, it's all love. Thank you.
We gotta have more on.
Yeah. Yeah.
A lot of people that bullshit with us.
Yeah. There's a lot of people we fuck with. You know what I mean? And, you know, not if we got to you, we're going to get back to you. You know what I mean? Like, it all happens for a reason. This is happening full circle for me.
I feel like we do this weekly to the point where, like, yo, whoever the fuck is listening, thank you. And it's like,
yeah.
We want to put every listener on, just random. Yeah. Just come on, because we do this weekly.
Yeah. If you want to come holler, you know.
52 weeks in a year, we can just have random listeners that's been listening and been supporting, and they deserve.
Yeah.
Because honestly, yo, when we record, I'm just like, who the fuck is listening to us right now?
But there's people who listen.
And we need to have them on.
Which we need to say thank you and put them on.
Because if you're listening... Let us know.
Thank you.
Let us know so we could have you on.
Yeah.
We want to talk some shit with you.
Email, comment, whatever.
Yeah. ASK399gmail.com.
We already know John B is going to comment.
Yes.
Okay.
I think he's the only one that comments.
Yeah. We're going to have you. Don't trip, dog. We're going to have you on next time you're here. Okay. San Diego.
Yeah. We need a translator anyways. Yeah.
The out of town people that are not in the Bay Area and you're
Canada, Philippines.
You just happen to be in the Bay Area.
SoCal.
On a Wednesday, Thursday. DM us, email us.
On a Tuesday, knowing
you're here out of town, you're going to come on.
Yeah.
For real.
For sure. It's a real homie vibe. You know what I mean? You sitting there spending your time with us and
got butterfly knives over here.
We appreciate
it. Might eat some fried chicken.
I'll put that down. Well, we appreciate it. You know what I mean?
Definitely. And it's
everyone that interlocked with us. Shout out to, was it pineapple one? It was a. The hot sauce. What was the hot sauce?
Double Loco.
Shout out to Double Loco. Shout out to Deli Man. Shout out to Schlappmann.
Schlappmann. Braised bread.
Braised bread. They really broke their foot off. We got another plate back there. Another plate in the kitchen.
Let's shout out Boogie Brown.
Hey, shout out to Ben. Shout out to Ben and Boogie Brown.
We'll have him on again soon.
Yeah, shout out to Boogie Brown. Shout out to...
Film on Mike.
Shout out to Lexi.
That was the most entertaining thing. One of my most entertaining episodes. That was one of my most entertaining episodes.
Shout out to Chewy. Shout out to everyone that's been on, but to follow up Chewy as far as us being born and raised Bay Areans, where Chewy was radio god to us and Lex came through and broke her foot off in this bitch. We need to have Lexi back.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
One of my favorites was Joker.
Yeah. Hey, and, shout out to OG Joker, man.
Yeah.
And Al Fresco.
Fresco was a good one.
That was like...
We had some gems.
I think you learned a lot about culture.
Yeah. Frisco culture?
Specifically Frisco culture, our generation. between 30 and 40.
Yeah.
And born and raised in San Francisco, you learn a lot about
just everything. Those two right there.
Yeah.
Yeah. And for all the hipsters, you know, we gave you the homie. We gave you the homie Evan Senior Sisig.
Hello.
You know what I mean? Your favorite Filipino food, probably.
Hello.
We gave you Bay Area. We had Bay Area Culinary Royalty on. We had Evan from Senior Sisig, and we had Miguel Ooh. Escobedo.
Hello.
Al Pastor Poppy.
Got Adam's Grub Truck. That was our Man versus Food.
Come on, man.
A couple weeks ago. You go to Off the Grid and you're going to see everyone there that's fire.
They was all $3.99. They fuck with us. You know what I mean? And two of the three were, actually, all three were on Food Network in a capacity. But two to three been rocking with us for over 10.
Yep.
You know what I mean? So
that's a decade.
That's
called a decade.
To show y'all,
thank you for clearing that up for us.
No, actually,
for those of you don't know, 10 years equals a decade.
That's a decade.
Over 10. I could not be more thankful for this outlet.
Episode 50.
Yeah. I cannot be more thankful for my brother Phil, for my brother Mono.
Hell yeah.
Shout out to Big John. You know you're here in spirit.
Hey.
Bugs.
We got to have Big John on for real.
No way. He's coming here, I think, in a week or two.
I'm going to be in Disneyland next week.
So he said week or two, so not next week, the week after.
He's going to be here in a week after.
I'm
a
holler.
Yeah, look.
We got to have him. We did have him on.
We did have him on, and Germs on episode 20. Shout out to Germs.
Was that episode 20?
That was episode 20.
I feel like the Momo episode was after that.
Yeah. Was it?
I think it was. Yeah, it definitely was.
The Momo episode, the ghost episode.
Shout out to Barna. Shout out to Teresa. Shout out to Jared. Shout out to Dr. X.
Dr. X. Yeah. We kind of forgot about that guy, but you can't forget about that guy.
You can't forget about that. We've seen that guy earlier with all his kids. He's walking out the house in socks and it's wet outside on that WPS. What?
Next level shit right there.
Yeah, that was.
I didn't know which one. What do you think is worse? Walking outside when it's wet out with socks on or barefoot?
I think socks.
Yeah,
because that's evidence.
That motherfucker did both.
He had socks. He had socks and he transitioned to taking off his socks and it was like.
Yeah. It was like the white girls in the club with no shoes on. Yeah.
Oh, goodness.
That's definitely some WPS.
But
like feet on the dashboard in the car. That's totally WPS.
Dude, that's asking to get killed.
Public bathrooms.
Dude, I remember partying in Burlingame back in the day. What was it?
FNAs.
FNAs.
Yeah.
And I remember Burlingame. I remember the bathroom like
in the
overfloated.
Overfloated.
All that. And the girls were still walking around with no shoes on inside the bathroom.
WPS?
Yes.
Google it, y'all.
Yes.
I love my gross, WPS. Dude. I love WPS. That's one of my favorite shit to do. Like, I had friends who had like
Wednesday's walking, a day for Wednesday. WPS.
Wednesdays would be hilarious WPSness.
Yeah. I'm sorry, but it's funny.
Yeah. We had Brandon real quick because they just bombed the show. Brandon, we had BJ. Mm-hmm. Who else, Mono? Who else? Who you think about?
I know G bombed it once or twice.
Yeah, yeah. We had him on.
Chewy. We had who else? Boogie Brown.
Filmo Mike. That was funny. Hey, Filmo Mike got great stories.
Dude, if you watch his IG stories, that shit is like entertainment on its own.
I think one of the dudes got mad at him yesterday. Did you see that?
Yeah, I saw that.
So you gotta film on Mike.
He got really mad.
He got mad at him. He's like, he doesn't buy anything. He doesn't buy. He got mad at dude because.
But they ended up making up at the end.
Imagine Mike's in his face every day. What was that? You gotta everyone take out their IG and they gotta show the first thing that's on their Let me see what you follow. Everyone take out their phone and you gotta show.
I'm trying to see our guests.
Whatever. Who was that?
First thing to pop up.
Yeah.
The first thing to pop up on mine. What is that? Is Tony Baker.
Oh, mine's Steph Curry. Curry. Phil, no, you can't reset, Phil. You can't press the new post button. It's Steph Curry. No scumbag.
Yeah.
No scumbag. See, why are you looking for shit? Scrolled
it 10 times already, Phil.
Yeah. What are you doing? You done
swiped it all the time.
Oh, okay. See, that wasn't what we seen before that made me ask this question. Sorry, I seen legs. It was legs. Hey. It's a different era. Would you date a girl that was an Instagram model?
Date? No. Fuck yes.
What? You would fuck anything.
No.
Just
saying. Let's be fair, Phil. Let's be fair.
I think
dating involves dating. Okay, dating. Dating, the definition of dating is bringing her to a family party.
Yes.
No, I would not.
She's solid.
That's the next episode. We should talk about what's the definition of dating.
She's solid, though. She's solid, but that's just her 9 to 5.
We should get an IG model on here and let's see if you would date her.
Okay.
Oh,
he said, okay.
Next episode.
Yeah.
All
right.
Yeah, bring it to my house.
See, that's why we get no girl guests here.
Just FYI, we do kill a bottle of Jamie for episode, so the girls beware.
It's all good.
Oh my god.
Oh, we had Lady Raya.
Yeah. Reach out to Raina. Shout out to Raina. Raina's fam. Raina's fam.
That's our cousin, man.
We eating OG. Yeah. Free 99 OG.
Sorry, episode 50, man.
I got bad memory. I gotta look through who we have.
Jocelyn Manalo, hey, the mayor.
Mayor
of Daly City. You know what?
You know what? After that episode, I had people come up to me like, hey, how did you get the mayor of Daly City?
That's the first thing people say is, how did you get the mayor?
I was like, you know Gus. Gus knows everybody.
Yeah, that's exactly what I say.
That's fam. Shout out to Jess.
You know him. He got everybody.
Jess is the homie.
That was a good look.
That was a great look. And Carl left me stranded here, and Jocelyn, she left and she came pick me back up in her mayor mobile.
What's her mayor mobile?
Mercedes.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know what I mean?
Okay, mayor mobile. Sitting on
something chunky. All
right. Mayor mobile. All right.
Anything else?
No, thanks for the chicken.
Thanks for the chicken. Okay, let me shout them out one more time.
We're Braised Plus Sign Bread on Yelp.
Yes,
Braised but on IG is different.
They have that same one on IG.
Okay,
but their main account they're trying to bump up SHLAP MUAN. Their fried chicken's on Schlap point.
Schlap one.
Yeah, Schlap one. That Schlap one. That shit slapping. Hey. What was your favorite dipping sauce?
I'm going to go with the orange.
Yeah, because you have nothing left. That was that orange habanero.
Orange habanero.
There's sweet, spicy garlic. Yep. That's the spicy peanut. Yeah. And
you put it over rice.
This shit goes.
See all this right here? About to be gone.
Yeah, there's another thing right there. Free 99 podcast. Anything else, Phil?
See y'all next week,
man. Yeah. Episode 50. Thank you for listening.
Thank you. Episode 50.
And if you're listening, you want to be on, let us know.
Love is love. Love y'all, man.
Have y'all on for sure. Yeah.
Peace.